And new tonight, President Trump defending his trip tomorrow to Kenosha, Wisconsin, after the police shooting of Jacob Blake and the deadly shooting of two protesters. Now, even though top leaders have pleaded with him to postpone the visit.
We're meeting with numerous people, and we have tremendous support in the state of Wisconsin, so I promise them when it all gets taken care of, we'll go.
Concerns, though, that it could exacerbate tensions and increase violence. Do you give any consideration?
Well, it could also increase enthusiasm, and it could increase love and respect for our country.
Omar Jimenez is out front in Kenosha. So, Omar, tell us, what is the feeling on the ground there ahead of the president's trip tomorrow?
Well, Pam, local and state leaders, specifically the governor and the mayor, still feel it's too early for the president to visit here in Kenosha, with the mayor saying that people here are still trying to heal over the course of what has been a chaotic week at moments here in Kenosha. Now, they are staying pretty tight-lipped over what the visit will actually look like tomorrow, but we did get a sense that it is going to take up a lot of local resources that up until this point have predominantly been going toward managing the protests and, in some cases, some of the violence that we've seen. Now, a major question in this was whether the president would be meeting with Jacob Blake's or even speaking with Jacob Blake's family while he was here. At this point, that does not seem likely. For starters, the father says he doesn't want to play politics and get involved. The mother, through their attorney, Benjamin Crump, says that they were waiting for a call from the president, but that the president didn't want to do it with the lawyers on the line. And the uncle flat out said that President Trump is a racist who stokes racial tensions. But nonetheless, President Trump will be here, and the mayor did announce he is extending the curfew through the rest of this week. The only difference is that the curfew will begin a little bit later, starting on Wednesday, as opposed to the 7 p.m. local time as it has. And then the National Guard, which of course has had a presence here over the course of this, says the over 1,000 of them that are currently in the area are expected to be here as long as necessary. Pam.
Okay. Omar Jimenez, thank you so much. And out front now, the Democratic mayor of Kenosha, John Antaramian, he and the Democratic governor of Wisconsin have both asked President Trump not to come tomorrow. Thank you for coming on, Mayor.
No problem.
Well, you heard what President Trump said this evening. I want to get your reaction to him claiming his trip to your city tomorrow could increase enthusiasm and love and respect for our country.
Well, I'm not one of those people who's going to tell the president what he can and cannot do. I would tell you, though, that I'm disappointed that he is coming. Our community has gone through a great deal, and there is no time right now for politics to be played. We would prefer the president had waited at least another week or so before coming to visit. Presidents are always welcome. I mean, all cities have presidents that visit at different times. The president is always welcome, but at this time, it's just the wrong time. Right now is a time for us to heal and to be able to look and inward and deal with the issues that we have to deal with.
And one of the reasons you've also said that now is not the time for him to visit is the strain on the resources. As you prepare for his trip tomorrow, what does that look like? And can you provide any more details of what his trip there tomorrow will entail?
I really cannot. There is no conversation at this point in time or information that we're giving out at this point in time as to the trip. I will tell you, though, that the National Guard has been extremely helpful, and we feel comfortable that we can keep the president safe and keep the public safe. Mostly, we need to try to make sure that there's calm in the community, and that is what we are hoping to maintain.
So even though you think now is the wrong time for President Trump to visit, are you willing to meet with him tomorrow when he is there?
Right now, we're not making any comments on his visit.
But you can't even tell us if you're willing to meet with him?
Again, I don't believe that I will be in discussions with the governor, with the president, but at this point in time, we'll leave it at that.
Okay. So a source familiar with the discussions tells CNN that Joe Biden's team is having talks about traveling to Wisconsin this week. Here's what Biden said about that earlier today. Let's listen.
Mr. Biden, you going to Wisconsin? I'm checking it out now. I hope to be able to do that.
So what do you think? Are you okay with Biden visiting, or do you think he should wait as well?
I would also prefer if the vice president waited until next week before he came. But again, regrettably, politics is now playing more and more into, because of the president's visit, as to what's going on. So we will see what happens. But like everything else, we'll move forward. The community is in the process of trying to recover. And we will greet anyone who comes in the end with respect that they deserve.
So you said you're okay with Joe Biden coming next week, right?
Right. I have always, my whole comment has been that it's just too soon for the president having to come here at this point in time. I would say it's a little soon for the vice president also. But in fairness, if the president is here tomorrow, then there really is no other choice, I think, than the vice president has than to also be here.
So President Trump has repeatedly tried to take credit for the reduction in unrest in your city. Here's what he said during tonight's press conference at the White House.
Tomorrow I'm going to a place where we move very quickly. You know that, in Wisconsin, and we move very, very quickly. And as soon as we move, that was the end of that. It was very well behaved.
And then this morning, he tweeted, if I didn't insist on having the National Guard activate and go into Kenosha, Wisconsin, there would be no Kenosha right now. What is your reaction to that, Mayor?
That again, is very disappointing for the president to tweet. The reality is that the city made the request for the National Guard to come in. The governor immediately dealt with it, and within 12 hours after the request had been done, the guard was in Kenosha.
So did that happen at the encouragement of the president? Because you heard him say that tonight at the press conference, that he had been asking for the National Guard to come in, and then finally the governor allowed that to happen. Is that true?
The governor actually had implemented the guard on Sunday or Monday morning early to have the guard come in. And so that was long before any discussions with the president.
All right, Mayor, thank you so much.